today, Mr. Mahathir, to my discovery, the author of the e-book, Ansi Books, and Ms. Mahathir, to my discovery, this afternoon we will present a presentation. We have a presentation on the Ansi Books. Well, we do this.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
There we are. Okay. My name is Matt, and I'm a teacher. Okay. As a teacher, I'm very interested in several things. One of them is how do my students learn? Okay. We often care a lot about what the students learn. We need to know the material. If we're teaching mathematics, we, the teachers, we need to know what? Mathematics, right? We need to know as much as we can about what we're teaching, okay? But we also need to know about how to teach, okay? And we also need to know about how people learn. How people learn is related to what? To their mind. And how is their mind, and are all people's minds the same? No. Some people learn better by what? Listening. Some people learn better by thinking, concentrating, maybe reading. Okay? Some people learn best by interacting, by talking to others. Okay? So you say something, I say something. Oh, now I understand. Okay? And there's other skills that people use. Each of these skills has a different effect on people's minds. And for some people, some skills are much better, better than others for helping them learn. Some people also learn better in different kinds of environments. Now, most of our students spend a lot of time in school. Well, all of our students spend a lot of time in school. They also spend time at home, doing homework. Those are two very different environments. They each have their benefits, but again, with different kinds of students, some have a much stronger effect than others. From my experience, when I was a student, for example, I was the kind of student who learned better with a smaller number of people, or by myself. So for example, if I was in class, and I was sitting in the back of the class, or even in the middle of the class, I felt like I couldn't understand. I was easily distracted by all of the people around me. If someone was talking near me, I couldn't hear the teacher. I couldn't concentrate. I couldn't remember. And I couldn't learn. So, in that situation, the best thing for me to do is sit at the front. If I'm sitting at the front, what do I have? I have the teacher, and me, maybe a small number of students, but it's mostly the teacher and me. I feel like I can understand, I can concentrate. So, how can we combine the idea of concentration and the teacher? One of the things that we have today, technology. Right? So today, if we're learning something like language, which usually uses other people, right? It's about communication. So language is what we use between us and other people. I read something that someone else has written. I listen to what someone else says. I speak so that someone else can understand me. So technology has helped us tremendously in all of those ways. Now, our students can have access to information from all over the world in order to help them learn what it is they need to learn. One of the best areas for this is in language learning. There are millions of students around the world right now who are learning English. And there are thousands and thousands of teachers who are helping them. some of these tools are available for free. Some of these tools are very expensive. But what we have here today is a tool that we're developing specifically to go with the books that you will be using with your students. Some of you may be already using with your students. And the benefits of what we are trying to create here is that we are using the technology to help those students through the different kinds of ways that they learn. We're trying to bring more of the teaching into their situations where they can concentrate on it. And they can learn in a way that reinforces what they've learned in class. Why do you think that's important? Well, how do you learn language? You can learn by listening. You can learn by reading. You can learn by studying grammar, by memorizing vocabulary, by talking to people, by listening to a teacher, by having someone fix your mistakes. Let's think about, though, that's learning in school, especially. Let's think about how you learn language. How did you learn language the first time? Did you learn by reading? No. Did you learn by talking only? No. How did you learn? You learned by listening. Who? Who were you listening to? Your mother,
yes,
and your father, maybe your aunts and uncles, your grandparents, the people around you, your brothers and sisters. Okay. So your first skill, when you're very small, what? You listen? You know what I say? Right. You learn something like... Okay. You learn something simple. Okay. Do you hear it only one time and then you say it perfectly? No. You hear your mother say, meh. Meh. Maybe you have to try it many times. But you also hear it many, many times. Okay? So this idea of repeating, repeating, repeating. Okay? This is something that is important in a learning process. And it's something that technology can help us to do. All of you who work in schools, you know that your time is very limited. When you have 40 students, you need to teach them something, as well as check their understanding, but you don't have time to do all that's necessary for all of the students every day, right? So that's why we have things like homework, right, for the students to do on their own. And this is a way that we can bring some of the benefits of the classroom into their homes or to their wherever they use their computer. So let's get started.
And we've designed the ebooks to be a companion, to be a companion to these books. So what that means is that whatever material is in the books, we also cover something very similar in the ebook version. Okay, and
Unit 1.
We know from
the generation gap.
A lot of the new technology that's been developed recently with computers and the internet, things like iPhones, iPads, and laptops, that the more that one of the key ideas in new technology is the idea of usability, of an easy learn what we call learning curve. That means that we want the technology to be powerful in its capabilities, but easy to understand and to use. So we wanted this program to be something that anyone, any student, can put on their computer and be able to use without having someone else have to teach them very much at all. So let's look here. We can see the basic beginning, the different tabs up here. So you're getting started, okay? That's probably the beginning. So if I were a student, what would I do? Maybe I start with
getting started.
Okay. Let's see. Activity one.
One. Listen and read.
Oh, listen. Okay, so that's easy. We've got the text. Where do I? We have a play button. Very simple. Let's listen. Wait, maybe I understand it better if I read it first. Some students, that's a good idea. Read it first. So then maybe we would read this first, okay? Maybe we see some new words. Where can I learn about new words? What's the word, what do we call a place where we can find new words in a book? In the back of the book, what do you have? Glossary. Do I see, there's a glossary. Okay, we have experience. Extended family. What does that mean? There's the meaning. Okay, now I understand. How do I say that? I see it could...
Extended family.
Extended family. Okay, now I know how to pronounce it. Okay, and I understand it from the translation. So now we can listen.
Do you visit your grandparents every weekend?
Okay. Where is the person speaking? If I'm reading?
Well, just my mum's parents. But I don't need to visit my other grandparents.
So we have highlights where you can see where the person is speaking. So if we're listening and concentrating, maybe we forget where we're reading and we can find it easily, right? The program helps with that.
You see, I live in a big house with my dad's parents and my uncle's family.
I see. You're part of an extended family then.
Let's see if I can say the same thing. How do I know if it's good or not? I don't have a teacher. I don't have anyone. Maybe I'm at home doing homework and I don't have anyone I can practice with. Right? So what can I do? I can... I see. You're part of an extended family then. And then I can listen to myself.
I see. You're part of an extended family then.
No, I think. Okay. It sounds about right. So they can practice with that, where they can actually listen to themselves. So this is something that gives them feedback, right? Where they can actually, they can learn to listen, where they can listen to the recording, and they can listen to it again and again, and they can listen to themselves, and they can listen to that again and again. So this builds feedback into the system. So this, again, is a way to help use technology to give them more chances to learn. Okay, so that would be the first exercise.
Two. Read the conversation again. Add the following sentences, to, T, or forms, F.
Okay, so you've read it again. So now let's see. All right, so after we read it, let's try and figure it out. Sam is part of an extended family. I think that was true. Anna is part of a nuclear family. I think that's false. Okay, so we've read it, we've tried the different answers, and... Oh, we only got one wrong, the rest were correct. Okay, so let's try again. Good. I don't have to do all of them again, only the ones that I got wrong. Okay? So that was false. There we go, all correct. Now, if we want to, if we are... you're doing a difficult activity and you feel really stuck at it. Ah, I've tried it, I can't get it right. What do you do? Well, we give them a little bit of help. After they try it three times, they can see the answers. So this is a way to give them a chance so that they have to try it. They have to try it three times. But if they still can't get the right answer, then we can help them. So this is, again, a way to get them to practice it several times if they need it. But we're not going to make it impossible for them to find the answers.
3. Complete the following definitions using the highlighted compound nouns in the conversation.
Okay, so in this case, so in the first activity, we have what skills were we using? Activity one, we were, what is it? Reading and listening and a little bit of speaking, okay? In the next one, we're doing an exercise.
Read the conversation again.
Right.
Add the following sentences to T or forms F.
In this case, this is about reading comprehension. Do you understand what you just read? Can you answer questions about that?
3. Complete the following definitions using the highlighted compound nouns in the conversation.
Okay. So here's the. So in this case, we're doing a gap-fill exercise where we have to use the new words in the conversation, the key words in the conversation. So let's see, which family consists of parents and children? That's a, you know, nuclear family. Okay. Forget to turn off the FP. Okay. So what is the care of children, especially when parents are at work? What is that called? Child care. Okay. What is the difference in attitude between younger and older groups?
Generation.
Okay. What are the rules of behavior that are typically accepted when people are eating at a table? Table manners. What is a person's opinion about a subject? And what is a big family that consists of parents, children, and grandparents, aunts, uncles, cousins? It's called a extended family. Okay, let's submit. Okay, what's the problem here? Okay, let's try reading a sentence. Nuclear is a family. What's the problem? It's only an adjective, so we need something else. Okay, number two, child care is the care of children. I think that might be correct, so let's check the glossary. We don't have it here, so maybe we need to go back to the beginning. Go back to that first exercise and check again. Where was that? We had nuclear family, child care. Okay, there we go. There's the answer. Child care. Okay, so let's go back. It does seem to be child care. So what could be the problem? Oh, I forgot a little detail. Yeah, so let's try that again. Okay, so we need They need to remember little details about good grammar.
Don't be lazy.
So, like Microsoft Word usually corrects if you forget a capital. Sometimes other programs do. So, and nuclear. A nuclear family. And again, if they try several times and they still can't do it, we can look at the answers as well. So as you see, yeah, the problem was, like we said, the first one was a grammar problem. We only use an adjective. The second one, you need to capitalize. So those details are important. So here's an activity that they can do. with another student. If they're working in a computer lab, for example, at the school, or if they're working, if they have a brother or sister or a friend they can work with at home. Still any answers? Okay, another kind of activity that we often use, especially for younger students, but it's also good for older students, is matching, right? It's a kind of activity where you have all of the information available, you simply need to make it go together. For some students, that's a very useful kind of activity, because they might, I found for me sometimes, only doing things like gap fill can be kind of stressful, because if I can't get the right answer, I can't remember all of the different things. So sometimes having an activity like this can be helpful. And this is a little bit more interesting than just doing it on paper because it's interactive. So let's see, nuclear, what words do we have? Nuclear style, generation family, no, generation, where is it?
Yeah.
Where is that? Generation map, generation?
Yeah. H.
Where is that? We have table manners, hair, what? Style. So I need to get rid of it. There we go. So you can simply erase it by clicking on it. Nuclear family. Soft one. Rings, very good. Sometimes it's easier to go back rather than forward. So what can go with food? We can go either way. We don't have to start with one or two. We can go from the left side to the right side. So what goes with food? School food, junk food. What goes with hold? Hold. Sorry?
Household.
Foot. Steps. School.
Children.
Okay. Let's check. Let's try that again.
Generation gap.
Yeah, where's that generation gap? Generation, we got a little glitch here.
There's
something wrong here. That one needs to be edited. But as you can see, it's very interactive, okay? It's easy to understand that you take from one to the other. You can go from the second to the first. And if you want to remove one, all you have to do is click on it. If you can identify your differences, in this case, rather than listening to the long dialogue, this is a very good way for them to practice. This is a good way for them, again, going back to that idea I said earlier about repetition, right? If you want to learn something, like learning language, and remember it well, you can think like a child, where you're going to hear the same thing again and again and again and again. To reinforce your memory, but also your understanding. When you listen to something like this, so if you're listening to something short, like if you can identify your differences with your parents, you can have a good relationship. You hear it again, play again. If you can identify your differences with your parents, you can have a good relationship. If you hear that, you can play just that one little piece again and again and again. That can reinforce your memory of it. And you will start to notice the small details. Because the more you understand, the more you hear it, the more you will remember it. But then when you look for specific details, like in this case, paying attention to the stressed words.
If you can identify your differences with your parents,
you can have a good relationship.
If you can identify, okay, let's try. If you can identify the differences with your parents, you can have a good relationship. Thank you. If you can identify your differences with your parents, you can have a good relationship. Let's try. Okay, so we're having some technical problems there, but again, you can listen to each of the small pieces rather than a long dialogue. So you can practice that, and you can memorize it, and listen for those small details. This is something that I, from my own experience, I know that this is effective because as I've practiced with learning other languages, I'm a native English speaker, but I've studied several languages. The more that I hear the same things again and again and again, the more it will stay in my memory. And I will, when I have a good example, like with this software, we use many native English speakers who have put their voices into this software. So I can help you with my confidence as well by listening. When I listen to this and I try to match my voice to it, and I can hear it many times and try to match it more and more, but also I can have confidence that I have a good example as well. So several things that this software is designed to do. One is to give students extra practice. Okay. Two is to give students extra practice in using some of the benefits of being in a classroom, such as being able to interact with a teacher, being able to listen as well as read and write, being able to speak as well, being able to, and then also being able to do activities that are interactive. So rather than only focusing on reading and writing with a pen or a pencil, they can interact by doing activities such as matching, where the software will show them their mistakes and they can try it again. So we have the benefits of a school, of being in a classroom, in the situation where they're working by themselves. We have the interactivity of it, and then we have the chance for them to repeat again and again and again, which we know is a very effective way for them to remember and to notice details that will help to reinforce their understanding of the language. And of course, the fourth benefit is that the idea of corrections. So we have the glossary. If the students forget the words, if the students want to better understand the pronunciation of individual words as well as the translation, we have the chance after the students have tried several times to see the answers, and then finally the students will actually have instructions for each section of the software. So we've designed it to be as intuitive or easy to understand to use, so the students don't need much instruction. But if they do, they will have the ability to find the instructions. How do you have access to this software? Do you have a book? What's on the back? Right here. This right here, this little sticker here, give you an access code hidden underneath that will give you a chance to access this software online. So you'll have a chance to vote. if I remember correctly, you have a chance to both access it online and be able to download a copy of this for you to give it a try. So I would encourage all of you to do that. And for me as a teacher, I'm always trying to find new ways to help my students and to use the material that I have in ways that benefit my students. So the book and the ebook are both carefully designed, but there are many different ways that they can be used. And I would encourage all of you to look over it, to give it a try. Maybe even send us some feedback on what you think is good, or even what improvements we could make in the future on the software. So I hope that you'll take some time to give it a try, and I hope that it will be very beneficial to you and to your students in the future. And one last thing, this learning involves many different things, but learning always comes down to one thing, the person who is actually learning. Our students, we can try many, many different things to put knowledge into our students. But in the end, it does always depend on the students themselves actually learning. And something like this can be a tool for those students to do more on their own, to become more independent, so that in the future they will develop the knowledge, the understanding, and the confidence that they will need to use these skills in the future, in their future studies and in their work. So we hope that it will be beneficial to you as teachers, and especially to your students. Thank you very much.